Now moving forward towards our non-technical session, which is career opportunities after BTech.
The first examination is GATE, Graduate Aptitude Test in Engineering. It is the main exam most of the students appear after you complete your BTech degree. After GATE, you can pursue your master's program. Most of the best colleges in India accept admission through GATE. The eligibility for the GATE examination is candidate must have completed or be in the final year of BTech degree. You can also appear in your final year while you are doing your BTech degree. There is no age limit for this examination, and there is no restrictions on the number of attempts. The syllabus and pattern paper is, the GATE paper contains two sections, general aptitude and candidate selected subject. You can select your subject from a 27 subjects given by the GATE examination. There are 10 general aptitude questions and 55 subject related questions. Questions are multiple type questions, multiple selected questions, and numerical answer type questions. The paper pattern is 30 questions of 1 mark, 35 questions of 2 mark, and hence the total question is of 100 marks. The future opportunities after GATE examination are postgraduate, MTech entrance, public sector undertaking entrance. You can pursue your PhD and research after GATE fellowship program in management. Now let's talk about our second examination, GRE, Graduate Record Examination. GRE is a great opportunity for students who want to study abroad. GRE is a standardized test that is required for many graduate schools in the United States and a few other countries. The eligibility for GRE examination is candidate should have an undergraduate degree, which is your BTech degree. There is no age limit for the examination. You can attempt this exam 5 times in a year on a rolling period. Once you have given a GRE test, you can give the next attempt after 21 days. Now let's discuss the syllabus and paper pattern. There are 3 sections in GRE paper: analytical writing, which consists of issue tasking and argument tasking. The analytical writing is given 30 minutes. And now the second section is verbal reasoning, which consists reading comprehension, text completion, and sentence equivalence, which also has 30 minutes, and has 2 sections containing 20 questions each. The third section is quantitative reasoning, which consists all about mathematics, which consists arithmetic, algebra, geometry, and data analysis, which is of 35 minutes and has 2 sections of 20 questions each. The future opportunities after GRE are, you can travel abroad to study in various universities such as Harvard, Stanford, University of South California. Many privileged universities accept their admissions through GRE. So it is a great opportunity for students to go for GRE who want to study abroad. Thank you.
ISRO and BARC. These are centralized agencies. Centralized recruitment board conduct exam for respective recruitments in these agencies. Talking about eligibility, candidates who have completed their BTech from recognized universities are able to apply. There is no restriction of number of attempts, but age limit of candidate varies according to the post. Looking forward towards syllabus and paper pattern of these exams, exams for engineering post in ISRO consist 80 objectives of total 240 marks. Each correct answer will be assigned as +3 and each wrong answer will be assigned as -1. For technical assistant post, exam consists 80 objectives of 320 marks and marking scheme is as plus 4 and minus 1. Exam for BARC consists 100 objectives of total 300 marks and marking scheme is as plus 3 and minus 1. You can see syllabus of respective examination on screen. If you get selected as assistant research scientist, after getting some experience, you will promote it to higher levels. Next is IIFP. IIFP stands for Indian Institute of Foreign Trade. This exam is mainly conducted for admissions to MBA in reputed college of IIFT at New Delhi, Calcutta and Kakinada. Candidates who have completed their bachelor scoring at least 50% of marks from recognized university are eligible to this exam. There is no limit of age and number of attempts. Exam consists of four sections: quantitative ability, verbal ability and reading comprehension, logical reasoning and data interpretation, and general knowledge. 3 marks of each right answer are assigned in first 3 sections, and 1.5 marks for each right answer is assigned for in last section. In campus placement, candidates are likely to get average 21.08 to 46.45 lakhs per annum. Companies like TCS, ICICI Bank, Amazon, IBM often visit IIFTs for their placement.
IES is the very well-known exam for the engineering aspirants, and it is held by the UPSC. The students of civil, mechanical, electrical and electronics and telecommunication engineers can apply this exam. Let's talk about the eligibility. Candidates should have completed any bachelor's degree from any recognized university in the four domains mentioned above. Minimum age is 21 years to 30 years. Candidate can appear for this exam for maximum six times. Let's talk about the syllabus and paper patterns. In this exam, three stages, as we know. First stage is preliminary, second main, and third is interview. In preliminary paper, there are two sections. First is general studies and engineering aptitude paper, and second is engineering discipline specific paper. Main paper contains two papers which are totally based on the engineering syllabus what we have studied in 4 years. Prelim stages paper is 500 marks, and main paper is of 600, and interview carries 200 marks. Now let's talk about future opportunities after ESC. Opportunity to work as an assistant executive engineer in different departments which are directly under the supervision of central government of India, like ministries, offices, engineer, defense engineer, border road engineer, communication engineer.
So our next exam is FCAT. FCAT stands for Air Force Common Admission Test. It is a special exam which is conducted by the Indian Air Force to conduct the officers in the IAF for the multiple posts like flying and general duty, and for the technical and non-technical posts. Talking about the eligibility, the graduates who have passed with minimum of 60% marks in the BTech or BE from the recognized university are eligible for this exam. The candidate's age must be in between the 20 to 24 years. And there is no restriction on number of attempts. You can give this exam and number of times. Talking about the syllabus and paper pattern, there are 100 questions in this exam for 300 marks. The marking scheme is plus 3 and minus 1. There are 4 sections in this paper. First one is general awareness, second English, numerical ability, reasoning, and military aptitude test. Talking about the future opportunities, it is a very special exam which gives the candidates an opportunity to be commissioned as an officer in the Indian Air Force and be posted at any Air Force stations across India. It gives you a chance to serve our country, and it is also considered as a noble profession across our society. And it is a proud movement for us and your family also. So our next exam is CAT, which stands for the Common Admission Test. It is a special exam for the candidates or students who wish to pursue the MBA degree after their UG studies. Talking about eligibility, the students who have passed the bachelor degree with at least 50% marks are eligible. There is no age limit on the age, and you can give the number of attempts as much as you want. So talking about the syllabus and paper pattern, the CAT paper is divided into three sections. First one is VARC, which consists of 26 questions, and a portion is reading, comprehension, paragraphs, and para summary. Second one is QA, which consists of 26 questions. Arithmetic, algebra, numbers, and geometry are the portions included. The third one is DILR, which consists of 24 questions, and it consists of data interpretation, logical reasoning. So there are 54 MCQs and 22 non-MCQ questions. Each question carries 33 marks, and the marking scheme is +3 and -1. Talking about the future opportunities, it is a very important exam for the candidates who want to pursue MBA in higher studies. Appreciable CAT score allows you to get admission in the IIMs, which is a prestigious institute in India. Also, it assures you a great career in the corporate sector in the multinational companies, and also gives you a blast future ahead. Thank you.
So our next exam is CDS, that is Combined Defense Service. The CDS exam is for those candidates who want to go in defense sector after their graduation. The CDS Combined Defense Service examination is conducted by UPSC for recruitment of officer in Indian Army, Indian Air Force, and Indian Navy. The candidate with a bachelor degree can give this exam. The age limit for this exam are as follows. For Indian Military Academy, it is 19 to 24 years. For Indian Naval Academy, it is 19 to 20 years. For Air Force Academy, it is 19 to 23 years. And for Officer Training Academy, it is 19 to 25 years. We can see from this that the candidate will give this exam from age 19 to 25 years. And there is no restriction on number of attempts of this exam. Talking about syllabus and paper pattern for this exam, the exam is mainly divided into three sections. The first one is English, the second one is general knowledge, and third one is elementary mathematics. English section involves mostly question on English grammars, question on paragraphs, phrases, and conditional statements. The general knowledge part involves the things which are happening around us in our country, and elementary mathematics, which involves the syllabus of most engineering mathematics, and syllabus which is declared by UPSC at that particular year. Each section has 100 MCQ type question, means for each section equal weightage is there, and exam is of total 300 marks. You will get +1 mark for each correct question, and there is negative marking system is also there, that is -0.33 marking scheme for each wrong answer. Then talking about the future opportunity after CDS, if any candidate cracks this exam, then he can get more job opportunities in Indian Army, Indian Navy, Indian Air Force, as well as Indian Coast Guard also. Candidate will get either administrative and combatant job, means he or she will get opportunity to serve our nation. Then our next exam is JAM, that is Joint Admission Test for Masters. Joint Admission Test for Master is a common admission test conducted every year for admission into Master of Science and other postgraduate science programs at Indian Institute of Technology, Indian Institute of Science, and National Institute of Technology. Then talking about the eligibility of the JAM exam, the candidate should have its bachelor degree from recognized university with at least 55% of its marks, and there is no restriction of number of attempts of this exam. Then talking about the syllabus and paper pattern of this exam, the exam is mainly divided into three sections. Section A, which consists of 30 marks, Section B, which consists of 10 marks, and Section 3, which consists of 20 marks. There is negative marking system is also there for Section A and Section 3. There are total 60 questions in this exam, and total paper is of 100 marks. The syllabus of this exam is varies according to the discipline chosen. Then talking about the future opportunities after the JAM exam, if any candidate will crack this exam, then he will get admission into various science postgraduate programs from India's most reputed institute like IITs, NITs, CFITs and IISCs. Candidate will get good opportunity to do scientific research in most prestigious institution in our India. So due to higher education from such institute of India, student will get well scientific knowledge and which is helpful to build our nation and for development of our country. Okay, thank you.